want to determine the derivative of the given function using the limit definition of the derivative, and then determine the slope of the tangent line at x equals negative 1. So here's our limit definition of the derivative. Notice here we're using h. Sometimes you'll see some textbooks using delta x, but I think when you're first learning how to do this, it's easier to keep x's and h's apart from x's and delta x's. Here we're given y equals x squared minus x, which is the same as saying f of x is equal to x squared minus x. So the derivative of our function is going to be equal to the limit as h approaches 0 of this difference quotient. Our numerator is going to be f of x plus h, which means we're going to take our function and replace each x with x plus h. So we'll have x plus h squared minus x plus h. And this is just f of x plus h. And now we have to subtract f of x. We have to be careful here because we have to subtract the entire function, so we'll have the quantity x squared minus x. If we leave off these parentheses, it would not be correct. We divide all of this by h. And just to double check before we do all this work, notice the numerator is f of x plus h minus f of x. So all of this is f of x plus h, and this is f of x. Now that we have verified it set up correctly, we can start to simplify this quotient. Now we have to multiply all this out, combine like terms, and try to simplify out this h. Right now the h is a problem because if we try to perform direct substitution, our denominator would be 0. Now I know it's easy to forget, but it is important that we keep writing this limit notation. The limit as h approaches 0. Now if we multiply x plus h times x plus h, we're going to have x squared plus 2hx plus h squared. Now just in case I lost you there, it looks like this. We have x squared plus hx plus hx, that's 2hx, and then plus h squared. Here we're going to clear the parentheses, which you can think of as distributing a negative 1, so we'll have minus x minus h, and then we'll do the same here. We're going to have minus x squared plus x divided by h. Now good things start to happen here. Notice how we have an x squared minus x squared, that's 0, and we also have a negative x plus x. And now if we look at all of the terms in the numerator, notice how each of them have a common factor of h. So now we'll factor out an h from the numerator. So we have the limit as h approaches 0. We'll have h. So if we factor out an h from 2hx, we have 2x. Factor out one factor of h from here, we have plus h. If we factor out h from h, we have 1 over h. And now notice that we have a common factor of h between the numerator and denominator, which simplifies out, leaving us with the limit as h approaches 0 of just 2x plus h minus 1. Well, as h approaches 0, this is the only term affected by h. So as h approaches 0, this limit is equal to 2x minus 1, which is f prime of x, or our derivative of f of x. So let's go ahead and take this information on the next slide and determine the slope of the tangent line. So if f prime of x equals 2x minus 1, the slope of the tangent line at x equals negative 1 will be f prime of negative 1. So we have 2 times negative 1 minus 1. So f prime of negative 1 is equal to negative 3. So the slope of the tangent line at x equals negative 1 is negative 3. And let's go ahead and verify that graphically. In red we have the graph of the given function, and so what we found was the slope of this tangent line, which is equal to negative 3. Now there's one more thing I do want to mention. If you had to determine the equation of the tangent line at x equals 1, notice how you would have to determine the point of tangency. So to determine the point of tangency, we'd have to substitute x equals negative 1 into the original function to determine the y-coordinate on the red graph. So f of negative 1 is equal to 2, which tells us the point of tangency is negative 1, 2. It's very important that we keep this straight. Subbing x equals negative 1 into the function gives us the y-coordinate of the point of tangency, but subbing negative 1 into our derivative function gives us the slope of the tangent line. We will look at more examples in the next several videos.